It's written in 1945 by Charlie Parker. This semester, we kind of devoted ourselves to Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. And it was recorded in 1945 in Copenhagen, Denmark. And just a tidbit about Charlie Parker, who was considered one of the greatest saxophone players of all time. He's like a Mozart of the saxophone. Everything that came out was perfect. And he said that for 3 or 4 years, he practiced 15 hours a day. Okay? Yeah? Now, he died when he was 35, which is so heroin addiction. But his music has lived on and on. And this is a 12-bar blues, and it was dedicated to Dizzy Gillespie's, secretary, and his name was Billy. And so they called it Billy's Bounce. So, here we go. You ready, guys? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. So we chose a song called A Night in Tunisia. It's on your program, and it's written by Dizzy Gillespie in the early 40s, and this is really one of his signature songs. And it's in the mambo form of music, which is, mambo is part Cuban, and it's really a dance. So it's similar to, well, rumba, the cha-cha. And he was, Dizzy Gillespie ended most of his career heavily involved in Cuban music. And his Cuban jazz brought real life to the U.S., to the world, really. So this is featuring one of our own, Tom Henry. So let's do it, guys.
Thank you.
jazz musicians here, and we found out she could sing, let alone play piano, and we found out that somebody arranged some songs for her, and one of them is called Mr. Jones, but we all remember Mrs. Jones, right? And that was from a musical, I'd Rather Be Right. And the music was written by Richard Rodgers and the lyrics by Lorenz Hart. It was published in 1937, and Mr. Jones has become a famous jazz song for Stan Getz, Tony Bennett, Bing Crosby, Art Tatum, and tonight we have Marcia Golding. So would you welcome her as she sings Mr. Jones? Dizzy Gillespie song called Manteca, and I think you're gonna love the soloists and the great
feel. This is a samba feel. So this is Manteca by Dizzy Gillespie.
Thank you.
for our last number, we'd like to do another Charlie Parker tune called Yardbird Suite. So, Charlie Parker heard Stravinsky's Firebird Suite, and so his nickname was the Bird. So he came out with the Yardbird Suite, and that's how we came up with this jazz tune.
And so I just wanted to thank all of the people here. This is parents of the kids that just played. And this is an unusual situation where we have these adults that came about as a result of the kids. There's a lot of people here that love music, and these kids totally love it. So I hope you can keep them involved and interested. This is one of the good things for kids, for sure. It's kind of interesting where this will manifest in their lives. I mean, college, it's a great bonding with kids and marching bands and just concert bands in college. College can be very alienating. There's not groups. And this is one big thing. And then later, we have in Pittsburgh a ton of community ensembles. And so this is one of them. And I'm actually amazed at how good this group is. I'm always blown away by the kids and what they do. The summer camp is amazing if you can do that for the kids. But with the adults here, one of the things is we are all of different levels and backgrounds. It may not seem that way, and that's the beauty of jazz, you know, because we can give whatever we can contribute. My background is I'm a classical tuba player in an opera. But, I mean, you know, like Guido. What's your main gig?
I have a 9-to-5. I work for Honeywell as an engineer for them, so. Project manager, so.
But anyway, if any of you, we have some people that are just getting back into instruments and they're kind of sitting in, and it's a great experience. If you want to join in, you're more than welcome. If you know somebody that might be interested, go to our website, www.pico.org, and look up adult jazz.
So, thank you all as we finish up, and let's all have some fellowship afterwards and get some food and talk a little bit, okay? So this is Yardbird Suite.